Good afternoon. My name is Jason Redula. I'm the Deputy Enforcement Chief with DLNR's Division of Conservation and Resources Enforcement. Just have a brief update. This morning, officers with the Division of Conservation and Resources Enforcement, along with Hawaii County first responders, responded to a report of an incident involving a commercial tour vessel which was operating in the area of the Kapoho Ocean lava entry. Apparently there was some sort of volcanic explosive event that caused hot molten lava to be hurled upon the vessel, causing numerous injuries to the persons on board. Right now we do know that in excess of 20 people have been injured. One has been injured seriously, others on a more minor scope. There is a multi-agency investigation occurring, which includes our partners at the U.S. Coast Guard, the Hawaii County Police Department, and the Division of Conservation and Resources Enforcement. I want to stress that at this time, this investigation is in the very early stages, and therefore we'll have no comment to make as far as what the investigation is looking like or any of the findings thus far. I'll be happy to take any questions that you have. I'll let the Coast Guard comment further on that. However, we do know that the captain of the port has declared a safety zone of 300 meters from the ocean entry.
Do we have indication that this boat was within that?
Not at this point. Right now, that's currently under investigation. It's one of the things that we'll be looking at. We don't know at this point. It's still premature to conclude that.
Can you confirm, just for clarity, because there was confusion this morning, to which tour boat company was involved in the incident?
Lava Ocean. It's Hawaiian Lava Ocean Tours.
Lava
Ocean Tours, sorry. So at this point, I'm not directly sure how Mr. Marzo is involved. However, he did provide a video, which is within the written press release. There's a link to the video.
Who is allowed to operate inside the safety zone?
So right now, the Division of Boating and Ocean Recreation has issued permits to, I believe, four vendors to operate within, to actually operate lava boat tours, and they have to comply with the captain of the port safety zone and those requirements.
If the lava ocean tour is one of them?
Yes.
And these four vendors can get up to 50 meters?
Right now, the captain of the port safety zone is 300 meters, so they cannot come closer than 300 meters from the lava entry.
But it's our understanding that some boats weren't given permission to get
You know, at this point, I don't know whether that's true or not. We'll have to defer to the Coast Guard on that.
Can you talk at all about any injuries sustained? I know, what's been going on right now.
I don't want to go into too much detail. However, we do know that at least one person was very seriously injured, and the others on a more lesser scope, particularly burns, those kinds of things. One person, though, was pretty critically injured.
So 23 people were injured, but how many people were on the boat?
We don't know the exact number at this point. That's still something that we're looking at.
So what is the process if a boat tour would like to go closer, with the safety zone? How would they go about doing that?
That's something that I'll defer to the Coast Guard on, but more than likely that's going to require Coast Guard permission.
Has there been any discussion with the Coast Guard to push that safety zone even further out?
I'm not aware of any of those discussions at this point.
Does DLNR want to do that?
You know, I don't think the department has a position on that at this point. That's something that we'll definitely be looking at, but also we're going to consult with our partners at the Coast Guard to determine the feasibility of that.
If the boat was found in fault, what criminal violations?
You know, it's premature at this point to discuss what violations might be found out of this. The investigation is going to determine several things, including whether or not there are any violations of federal or state law.
What violations would bring them from the DLNR?
You know, there are permit conditions. Whether or not any of those conditions were violated is part of the investigation, so it's too early to comment on that.
And has there been a call to have safety sites on land, just so that the tourists can come or visitors, residents can come see the lava from a safe point of view? Can you talk at all about that, about what the department's position is on safety?
You know, at this point, the department encourages the public to follow all of the emergency rules that are in effect and all of the directions from the Civil Defense Agency, which basically means view lava at a very safe distance. Do not go into the restricted areas unless you have the proper authorization to do so. So really it is a very individual compliance thing where everybody needs to be responsible for their own safety and to follow all of the laws, regulations, and get the necessary approvals.
Can you just tell us what the fines are, though, if let's say, someone goes beyond the Coast Guard safety zone? Do you know specifically what that is?
So I cannot comment as far as the penalty for violating a Coast Guard safety zone. That's something that I'll defer to the Coast Guard on. But at this point, if state law was violated, it'll depend on what law was actually violated to determine what the penalty is going to be.
Thank you.